they start to this Sunday morning. Celebrate good times. Come on. Welcome to Sunshine Salvos on this beautiful Sunday morning, the 21st of November, where we gather together here in this digital space. But we've got some good news, my friends. And it is simply this, that recent lifting of restrictions here in Victoria has given us the green light across many faith communities to be able to return to gathered worship, which we will be doing at Sunshine Salvos next Sunday. I'm going to talk a little more about that a little later in the announcements, but we've got a lot to celebrate. There's a lot of joy in and around Melbourne at this time. I know just yesterday, the Shine ladies and a few other extras had a fantastic lunch and afternoon, just enjoying each other's company, enjoying, full of joy, just having the opportunity again to be out and about. Lovely to see so many faces without masks, just enjoying life in its fullness. Lots of things to celebrate. And today in our worship time, we are going to focus on the theme of joy, because if there is a season that radiates joy, then it really is spring. And so we focus on joy today, the things that bring joy to our hearts. And when we talk about that a little later, we'll understand it's not just the things that come out spontaneously in joy, but it's also the deep joy that we enjoy in who we are, in the God whom we believe, and in the faith that we have. It is great that you can join us today. Of course, we gather on sacred lands wherever we are, and I pay tribute and acknowledge the Wurundjeri people of the Kulin Nation, the traditional custodians of the land where I am gathered here today. I pay my respects to their elders of the past, those here in the present, and honour the aspiration of future First Nations leaders in our great Southland of Australia. And as I always do, proudly state again the commitment of the Salvation Army, Australia Territory, to the process of conciliation with First Nations people here in Australia, doing our best to achieve justice for them. The lands where we're gathered on today were never ceded. They were, they are, and always will remain Aboriginal lands. With great joy, we start this worship service today with a lovely call to worship. I bring it to you now. Would you join with me in this joyous celebration and thanksgiving for some of the very basic things of life that we should give thanks for today? Thank you, Lord. Thank you for all the gifts that you have given me today, for all that I have seen, all that I have heard, and all that I have received. Thank you for the water that woke me up, for the soap that smells so good, and for the toothpaste that refreshes. Thank you for the clothes that protect me, their colour and their style. Thank you for the food that sustained me, the cool and that welcome glass of water. Thank you for the car that took me wherever I wanted to go, the fuel that made it go, and the company of a fellow traveller. We thank you, Lord. Thank you for the trees that nodded to me on the way. Thank you for the wind that caressed my face. And thank you for the grass by the side of the road. Thank you, Lord, for the tranquil night. Thank you for the stars. Thank you, Lord, for the silence. Thank you for the time, Lord, you have given me. Thank you, Lord, for life. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your grace. Amen. The joy of the Lord is my strength. That's a truth to hold on to. That's a deep truth and a deep joy to cling to and to express our praise to God for. That the joy of the Lord is that stronghold, that thing, that very real anchor that gets us through the tough times in life. The joy of the Lord is our strength. We're going to worship this morning with this hymn, this modern day expression of praise to God. The joy of the Lord is my strength.
Though the tears may fall, my song will rise, my song will rise to you. Though my heart may fail, my song will rise to you. While there's breath in my lungs, I will praise you, Lord. In the dead of night, I'll lift my eyes to you. Though the waters rise, I'll lift my eyes to you. While there's hope in this heart, I will praise you, Lord.
That's a real toe-tapper, that song. The joy of the Lord is our strength. I hope it's your strength at this time, and I hope there is much joy that you're feeling in just approaching today and what lies ahead tomorrow. There's optimism in the air, and there should be, and you should have real reason to feel optimistic for what lies ahead. We're going to move into a time of prayer. And even in prayer, even in this time, when we come into an attitude of prayer, that doesn't mean that we lose our joy, because there is a deep joy in knowing that we have a God who listens to our prayers, who answers our prayers. We have a God who's listening, and he's here right now, ready to hear our prayers. Would you join with me in this prayer time as we raise to the throne of grace this morning these petitions, these praises on behalf of Sunshine Salvos?
Thank you.
Amen. Some announcements and some important announcements to make. As I mentioned right at the start, for those who have been waiting for and longing for that day that we would return to gathered worship at Sunshine Salvos, that day is near approaching. Sunday, the 28th of November, we will be returning to gathered worship on a Sunday morning at 10 a.m. And we very much look forward to that. So come along, make sure that you're a part of the joyous festivities of that day, that return to worship. It's been the best part of 4 months since we've gathered in worship. And so I know that many of you will be looking forward to catching up with each other, brothers and sisters in Christ, sharing fellowship together and having a good laugh and catching up on the news of the day. And also, of course, coming together to worship our God at Sunshine Salvos. Be there next Sunday at 10 a.m. We have other things happening, of course, because in this time of renewed activity, we have things coming up, such as a Bunnings barbecue next Saturday at Caroline Springs. If you want to be a part of that, contact Captain Fung or myself, and we can make sure that you have a spot in the roster to cook some snags and serve some sausages and get out and about contacting people and raising necessary funds for Sunshine Salvos. So this Saturday, there is the Bunnings barbecue at Caroline Springs. And the following Saturday, on the 4th of December, there's another Bunnings barbecue, but at this time at Bunnings in Sunshine. If you can't come to Caroline Springs, then see if you can come along to Sunshine and be a part of that. Those two fundraising events are coming up over the next two Saturdays. We also have, at the beginning of December, the opportunity given to us at Sunshine Salvos to begin Christmas gift wrapping at Sunshine Marketplace. If that's something you would love to do and do well, then again, contact Captain Fung or myself and we'll ensure that you're a part of that wrapping roster. That is a great activity and a great means of service to the community, also a great fundraiser for our programs at Sunshine Salvos. Come along and be a part of that as well. There's other activities beginning to happen at Sunshine Salvos. I know some of the groups that normally use our facility during the week are starting to return to us. We've had an Alcoholics Anonymous group just return this week to us for their weekly session together. We've had also in December confirmation that Compassionate Friends, our friends who run a suicide and bereavement support group, will be returning to us in December. That's important for them because Christmas is always a tricky time for people in that space of loss and support. So it's great to have them back. We've got another pop-up vaccination hub happening this coming Friday night at Sunshine Salvos. Lots and lots of things are starting to roll again. It's great. It's just a joy to be able to be a part of, again, a renewal of activity and seeing that there are good things happening and that we at Sunshine Salvos are, again, in a practical way, helping to do our best to serve those in need in our local community. That's the announcements I have. Of course, the big one being, as I say again, a return to gathered worship next Sunday, the 28th of November at 10 a.m. Of course, that doesn't mean that this online service will cease. It will continue on. We will continue with this online service for those who aren't able to come to Sunshine for gathered worship. This online service will continue into the future. And of course, we come towards Christmas. And it's lovely that we can come back to gathered worship next Sunday, because next Sunday marks the beginning point of the Advent season. It's the first Sunday of Advent, next Sunday. So it's a great reason to come back together. It's a great reason to begin that journey again this year on the road to Bethlehem to worship the Christ child. Christmas time. That's all the announcements I have for this morning. It's a lovely song, a hymn of the church, a powerful song, a song that's often synonymous with Christmas time. It's that song, "Joyful, joyful, we adore thee, God of glory, Lord of love." We're going to enjoy that worship song this morning. I invite you to enter into this worship time to sing to your heart's content, joyfully, joyfully adoring our Lord as we worship him. Joyful, joyful, we adore you, Lord. Amen. I hope that you found that a wonderful time of refreshing joy to again express your love, praise, and joy to God for all the good things of life and the blessings we have. a Bible reading I bring to you today. It's taken from the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 35, verses 1 and 2, and then finishing off with verse 10. Isaiah chapter 35, verses 1 and 2, and then verse 10. Of course, here it is for you to have a read of before I begin. Isaiah 35, verses 1 and 2, and verse 10. Even the wilderness will rejoice in those days. The desert will blossom with flowers. Yes, there will be an abundance of flowers and singing and joy. The deserts will become as green as the mountains of Lebanon, as lovely as Mount Carmel's pastures, and the plain of Sharon. There the Lord will display his glory, the splendor of our God. Those who have been ransomed by the Lord will return to Jerusalem, singing songs of everlasting joy. Sorrow and mourning will disappear, and they will be overcome with joy and gladness. May God add wisdom to the reading of his word and give us right understanding and interpretation in its meaning for our context today. Yesterday, it was lovely to get out and about with the shine ladies. Now, it wasn't just me. I wasn't the token male, the only one there. There was another male, Major Ian, who was with us as well, and I'm thankful for that. It was lovely just to be out and about, to have a beautiful lunch. But the thing that struck me the most about being out yesterday, it was a lovely day, and there were lots of people around enjoying lots of great food, and there were very, very few masks in sight. And that was noticeable to me. We've become very used to a world of masks. We've become used to seeing people within the context of protection. And we've become used to seeing and recognizing faces that are half covered, where, if we're really honest, we can't really tell or establish what's truly going on in someone's face when they're wearing a mask. Yes, we can see their eyes, and the eyes speak a lot. But we don't often see the rest of the face. We don't often see the mouth that might be smiling, or the joy that might be in someone's expression that's hidden by a cloth mask. And so yesterday, to see without any filter, without any cloth mask, without any coverings, the sheer joy of people living life fully and freely, having a great time with friends and family over lunch, that struck me. It's the simple things like that that I think through a global pandemic we often just take for granted. To be able to sit and enjoy a meal with friends or family without having to wear a mask, where people can fully engage with each other without anything coming in between, so that the fullness and the expression of joy and life can be freely seen and expressed. Those things are precious. Those things we shouldn't take for granted. Those things yesterday I thanked God for, in seeing children and parents and others smiling, laughing, being joyful. We shouldn't take those things for granted. We should thank God for those most simple pleasures, those simple joys of life. Joy is one of the fruits of the Spirit. Joy is a basic foundation of who we are as human beings created in the image of God. Our God is a God of joy, and He has placed within us joy. Joy to be expressed, joy to be experienced, joy to be that deep, settled contentment in who we are and where we find ourselves in life. Today, we focus on joy, and we're in the season of joy because spring is the season of life, and life is and should be a joyous thing. And so when we come to the scripture that I just read from the book of Isaiah the prophet, we find the Israelites again dreaming of a time when they will experience great joy, when they will experience liberation, when they will experience a release from their exile, just as we have been released in recent times from the exile of lockdown. So the Israelites dreamed of that time when the very deserts of their homeland would be blooming into joy, that their joy would even be so overwhelming, so all-consuming, that it would just spring up through nature itself, and the deserts would bloom with flowers and greenery to become as green as the mountains of Lebanon. These beautiful images, these beautiful aspirations of joy. And that final verse that I read, that the joy of the Lord, those who will be coming back to Zion, to Jerusalem, they'll be singing songs of everlasting joy. And sorrow and mourning will disappear, and there will only be joy and gladness that will overcome those who are returning home. I have a real sense, just as the Israelites dreamed of that time when they would be freed from exile into a great experience of joy, I have a sense that there is that same feeling of joy at this time for those of us who have been locked down for so long in the most locked down city in the world, that we finally have been released and that we are enjoying this moment for all of what it is and for all of what it brings. And we should enjoy this moment. We should be living in this moment, enjoying it, and not taking it for granted. And I'll tell you why. Because even as I speak, while we're experiencing freedom, a lifting of restrictions, a return to gathered worship, a return to be able to do the things that we've always regarded as normal, having lunch with our friends and family, not worrying about numbers, not worrying about masks, while we're enjoying that freedom, countries in Europe at this very moment are going back into lockdown. As the winter comes in the northern hemisphere, and as the temperature drops and the air is getting colder and the season changes, so COVID has come back to afflict and haunt countries in Europe. And we're seeing countries like Austria and Germany coming back into lockdowns, whilst booster vaccinations are being rolled out. I say for us here, those of us who've known what it's like to be locked down more than anyone else in the world, who are enjoying this moment at this time, enjoy this moment of freedom. Thank God for it. Thank God in this very moment that next week, those of us who come and gather as a normal part of our life at Sunshine Salvos on a Sunday morning, thank God that we can again do that next Sunday. Thank God for the liberties that you have already begun experiencing again. Some of them are basic things, but some of those things are precious and should not be taken for granted. Shopping, eating, spending time with family, having visitors over, doing the things that we love doing that express the fullness of life. Give thanks to God for every single one of them. And this is my encouragement to you also this week. Find that thing that will bring you joy this week. And it may be something that's regular or familiar to you. It might be something that you have enjoyed since coming out of this lockdown time. Or it might be something new that you're going to give a go. You're going to try. It could be a new restaurant. It could be a new food that you're going to eat. It might be a new plant that you're going to try and plant in your garden. Give something new a go this week. Something that will bring you great joy. Something that will make you feel good inside. Something that will be creative. Something that will connect you with your Creator. Something which you can thank God for. Find that one thing this week and give thanks to God for it and enjoy the joy that comes with whatever that will be for you. As I said previously, joy doesn't have to be the balloons and the spontaneous party poppers and all of those things that just burst out. Of course, joy is that wonderful thing that does burst out. But joy is deeper than that. Joy runs deep. And in the Christian faith, we have a faith. We have a deep joy that resides deep within, that is our place of pure contentment for who we are. Right in the center of the very palm of God, right in the center of His will, that gives us peace, that brings us deep satisfaction, that gives us a deep sense of happiness and the deepest sense of joy there can be. So whilst this week you participate in something that's going to be joyfully exuberant, I also encourage you to find that quiet place where the joy of the Lord is your deep contentment in who you are and how wonderful He is and how good He is. May this week for you be dominated and punctuated by moments of joy. And may God bless you this week joyfully as you continue to adore Him and praise Him through the living of your life in all the fullness of life in and through the grace of Jesus Christ. May God continue to bless you and may you experience great joy this week. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, that the moments of joy that we experience in life are amazing and that they come as a surprise sometimes and they come in the moments we least expect them. But we thank you for those moments where we are surprised by joy and that we do find ourselves just amazed and in awe of how wonderful you are. Lord, we praise you and we give thanks to you. We joyfully adore you. We love you. Lord, this week, allow us to enjoy the deep joy that we have in you. And give us something new in our week this week that will also bring us great joy. Bless us, we pray this week in Jesus' name. Amen. When I think of deep joy, I think of the things in life that I'm so deeply indebted to God for, so deeply grateful for, those places of deep gratitude that I have for how good God is and how blessed I am. And it's when I think about those things in life, like family, like friends, our faith community, my work, my calling, those things that bring me deep joy. I think of those things and I thank God for them, and I ask myself the question, how could I keep from singing when I reflect on those wonderful blessings from God? Enjoy this final hymn this morning, and you might like to ask yourself that same question. How can you keep from singing when you reflect on the blessings that God has given you in your life? That's a hymn of deep joy, and I give thanks to God for all the blessings that we have and wonder how we can keep from singing because God is so good. Amen. A benediction I bring to you this morning, and it's simply this: now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only God, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, be all glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forever and ever. Amen. May God bless you this week. May you find those places of deep joy where your gratitude and praise to God is expressed, but may you also find those surprising moments of joy where your exuberance and enthusiasm for life just pours out spontaneously. May God bless you this coming week. We're going to be back here in this space, in this online space next week. We're going to continue for the last Sunday of spring because we're soon to move into summer. But as I said before, it's the first Sunday of Advent. And so we're going to begin to think about summer and the Christmas story and begin that pilgrimage, that long, dusty, dry road walk to Bethlehem. May God bless you with much joy this week, and we will see you again soon. Bye for now.